And a very good afternoon. I'm Dr. Rahma, and this is my friend Liana, Dr. Esther, and Dr. Dayang. I'm from PSK as well as Dr. Dayang, Dr. Esther from PPIB, and Dr. Liana from FSMP. So, hope you still can stay with us, though we are the last group. So we're going to present the SWOT analysis on the blended learning in the perspective of UMS students. I think I better to talk from here. So I will present on the strengths and the weaknesses, and the other two will be covered by my friends. So the strengths of the blended learning, we think we give the students autonomy to study, when to study and how to study. And this blended learning actually give the students better engagement. It's like we implemented gamification, so that kind of approaches actually will create their interest to study the topic. And other than that, actually they can do learning through their mobile. I think if you ask your students, most, or I think all of them, will have a smartphone, so they can read the lecture notes wherever they are, in the bus or even in the theater if they want to read out. And then actually this blended learning through the smart tool, we can give them the real-time access to feedback and result. As one of our friends said, sometimes in the class they are afraid to sort of asking. If you ask them, they will be quiet. It's like no one in front of you. But if you give some platform for them to ask any questions through the smart tools, actually they can, they will ask you. They will ask you indirectly, and then some of the friends actually will give feedback, meaning it is not only two-way, it's a multi-way. Not only from the lecturers, actually it also can be answered by the other students, the excellent student maybe. And then, so we go to weaknesses of the blended learning. I think this is, most of us knows that our connection in the UMS is not that very well connected, especially for the students, and they don't have enough data. Compared to us, I think we can pay the data itself. But the students, I want to for me, I try to get them engaged. It's like more to constructivism during the first early class. It's like I want to have a quiz, but they said, no, doctor, we don't have internet. It's like, I feel demotivated because I cannot get a better engagement with them, because in my class, they actually already learned the topics in their pre-university class. So, I think that one can be improved. Second is stress-induced factor, time-limited, meaning sometimes actually some of the students are MPP, or actually they're having co-curriculum works, and we give them a kind of a very short time, and they can't access, or maybe due to connection problem, they can't really access to the blended learning. To the quiz, for example. So other than that, the weakness is we think big data can be too overwhelming. It's like a tsunami thing. So when it is big data, we call it data tsunami things. So it's like one of our friends already mentioned as well, like different lecturer might be using different platform. At Moodle, Kahoot, and SmartTool. Even in our UMS, also promoting the Google's things. It's like, which one we should focus? Too many, we can't focus, actually. So I think maybe in the perspective of UMS student, we better stick to one platform. I think at the moment, we are using the SmartTool as our official official platform, isn't it, for blended learning. But sometimes we even create our IDP program to use Google Things as our backup platform. I think that's all from me, and I will give to my friend to discuss on this.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Rama. So I will continue with opportunity and trends. Okay, reflecting on the opportunity, online exercise provide flexibility, especially in timing for certain classes that or activity that difficult to accommodate. Okay, besides it, provide the content uniformity, which is a uniform reach of course content or assignments through the platform, and also it can compensate for faculty shortage. For example, single teacher can enroll any numbers of students at one time. Okay, and for the trees, we found that they mostly okay by using a blended learning, student tend to increase the plagiarism tend to increase. Okay, and also the ID theft. Okay, for example, another student can use their friend's ID, okay, to complete assignment for others, and cyberbullying. For example, during the online session, for example, chatting or forum. Okay, one can condemn another one through online, and also distraction. The distraction, for example, when you do the online activity, you tend to multitasking, so the student can be distracted, and lastly, the blended learning at one point can replace teacher job, maybe have 100%, who knows. Okay, that's all from us. Anything to top up, my friends?
From my point of view, actually, what I want to say is actually like what Dr. Fong mentioned from the previous group, that this technology in learning is supposed to make our life easier and supposed to help us to teach and make the student understand. But I don't think it's applicable in all in all field, because the element of a hands-on and seeing the subject is also very important. In our faculty, like faculty of medicine, we need to have the hands-on. I mean, because study of a human being is always changing and it's not fixed like our online resource. So we need that also. But this technology, TTEL, is really good compared to the previous traditional teaching in the field of medicine, I think. Okay. I think that's all.
Esther?
Okay, maybe I'm the last one. Nothing much to say, but I think technology complement our teaching. It shouldn't replace the teacher per se, but maybe it can complement our teaching, and it should be based on. I like this one. I always whenever I want to use technology, I would like to base it from Mistra and Kohler theory, the technology TPCK, technology, pedagogy, content and knowledge. So you have to combine all this and to create the content which is very useful for the students to use. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you.
Your name again?
Esther.
Esther?
Yeah.
Esther won a gold award
recently. Yeah.
Only last week.
Yeah, last week.
Can you just give me 2 minutes, share the highlight of how come you go, win a gold award for your own?
Oh, okay. The project is actually a collaboration with
technology-enabled learning.
Yeah. So it is actually a scavenger hunt. Usually I just use it in a conventional way, where I ask my students to go to the library, to PPIB, and then to, for example, like they have to discover something, like a clue, but they have to answer some questions first. For example, maybe they have to list 10 types of verbs, and then once they have already managed to get all the answers, they can get the clue. And from that clue, they will go to another location, for example, from the library to PPIB. But it's very conventional, where they are using pen and paper. So when I collaborate with one of my colleagues from FKI, Siti Hasna, and she gave me the idea, I have the content, she has the skills, and then we work together, and from using pen and paper, we transform that activity into augmented reality. It's something like Pokemon Hunt, Pokemon Go, where you have to catch that icon or cartoon image, and then once they capture that image, and then they will go to another location. So we won a gold medal for that project, and we will be representing UMS in August. Yeah, in UMS. Yeah. Thank you.
Collaboration. Yeah, collaboration. Synergy, yeah. Okay, and this will always help. And as a young people, I would encourage you since young, okay, to try to work with certain partners or a group, okay, win-win situation.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, come, take a picture. Come, take a picture. Come.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.